Alright, what's up guys? In this video, we're going to take a deep look into the King's Indian slash Pirc. I'm going to go through all the different variations, the plans, the ideas, and what you want to try to do. So we're going to start with E4. So E4, when they go E4 and D6, this is actually technically a Pirc, or a Pirc, however you want to say it. But you kind of have the same plan, so it doesn't really matter. And King's Indian obviously sounds cooler. So Knight F6. So let's say, remember, if early E5, capture, trade queens, and then knight g4, you're going to win one pawn, maybe even more. If they're really bad, you spork them, and you win the rook. But if you're watching the advanced video, you probably aren't going to see that too much. So knight c3, more standard. So g6, so let's start with late e5. So late e5, this is a little bit more reasonable. If we capture here, take, and trade queens, they can play knight takes now, and this isn't as clear. And I wouldn't go into an endgame, at least I wouldn't, unless I really think I have some kind of big advantage here. This is just like start from scratch, let's see what happened kind of position. Maybe even a little bit better for white, because I think after f4, he's going to have a bit more space. So if late e5, we're going to go knight to d7, with the idea of bishop g7, c5, knight c6, eventually attack this shaky center. If they capture on d6, we just play c takes d6, no problem. And then we continue with the same plans as before. So now, instead of early e5, let's look at a more classical approach of knight f3. If knight f3, we fianchetto. Now the three kind of main bishop moves that you're going to see. If bishop g5, we're just going to go h6. So h6, if he takes, and now we have the same kind of plans. This bishop is now the only dark square bishop. It's the sheriff of the dark squares. So this bishop can get very, very strong if you go c5. So this, we're very happy with. If bishop h4, now we always have the option of playing g5. We don't have to play it now, but we don't have to worry about queen d2, bishop h6, and all that kind of stuff now. So he kind of showed his hand too fast in if they go bishop g5. Now if they go bishop d3, we're going to castle, knight c6. And here, if they go d5, we just go knight e5, capture. And now the plan is knight e8 and then f5. So there's two main maneuvers that you're going to see. I think this is the first time you're seeing this one, so knight e8 and then f5. And if they capture, we always play pawn takes to get those pawns in the center and try to win material, get an attack, all that kind of stuff. Now, instead of d5, if they go bishop e3, so here we can go e5. So e5 we can do because you do not have to worry about him trading queens. So we'll see very soon after when we have to worry about it. So if they capture, we go knight takes, pawn takes. And then our next move is going to be c6, and we call that dominating the knight. Because now the knight has no good squares to go to after c6. So if they don't capture, if they go d5, we just go knight e7. Knight e7, then you know this maneuver. Knight e8, and then pawn to f5. Now if they capture, like we were saying before, we play pawn takes to have great attacking prospects. And if they don't capture, if they go rook d1, we just go f4. We get that hook in, and now we're going to go h6 g5, and the fun begins. Now, instead of bishop d3, they go bishop to c4. Bishop c4, we're going to castle, knight c6. Remember, d5, the same kind of thing. Knight e5, and then eventually push f5. Now, here we do not want to go e5. If we go e5 here, we got to deal with this queenless middle game. And I've seen my students play this sometimes, and it just seems like white's even better here. It's not even like it's equal. White just has a much more easy time in this position. So what you got to do, if they can potentially trade queens, is the next golden maneuver, knight to d7, and you're going to see this all the time throughout this video. Now we can go e5. If they capture, we just go knight d takes. Now we can try to go bishop g4. We're hitting this bishop, and this diagonal is open, so black is very happy in this position. And if they don't take, you know the other maneuver, we go knight e7, and then we're going to push f5 and start that kingside attack. So that's what we're going to do if bishop d3, bishop c4, or bishop g5. Now here, instead of knight f3, kind of a classical approach, if they go bishop e3, generally what this kind of means, especially here, is they're trying to castle queenside. So if they go queen d2, here we actually cannot punish queen d2. Like normally knight g4, you'll see this in the dragon a lot, knight g4 is a very good way to punish white for not going f3. But here, I was looking at it for a bit, and bishop g5, and it's not so clear, and I don't really think it's worth the trouble of going knight g4. So all we have to do here is go castle, and if they go early bishop h6, we capture on h6. So take, now we're going to go c5 and attack the center slash queen side. So whenever they're attacking you on one side, that is their strong side, you got to hit them on their weak side. where they're not ready for the attack. And that is going to be the queenside or center, and that's why we go c5 here. Now instead of queen d2, the more standard, and what I see probably a lot more, is f3. So f3 we go castle, queen d2, and now rook e8. The idea of rook e8 is to not allow them to trade off the dark square bishop. Remember, you always want to keep this bishop, and they want to get rid of this bishop so that they can attack you. So now, if they go bishop h6, you just go bishop h8. And now, since the rook is on e8, you don't have to worry about them going bishop takes f8. So instead, rook e8 to prevent that. So queen d2, rook e8. Now, most of the time, you probably see castle queenside. Now, the way to attack here is c6. So c6, h4. Normally, they try to attack you when you finchetto on the h-file. Here you want to go h5. So h5 to lock down this side, and now you can start focusing on the attack over here. So knight e2, you're going to go b5, knight g3, and now b4. Now when they go knight e2, the way to continue the attack here is queen a5. Queen a5, king b1, and now c5 to open up this bishop. After capture, you can think about moves like bishop e6, putting pressure on a2, and black has a very, very good attacking prospects in this position. So that's what we're going to do if they castle queenside. Now instead of castle queenside, f4. F4 is, I think it's called the Austrian. It's another way for white to kind of get an attack here. So bishop g7, castle, bishop d3, and now whenever there's a pawn on f4, generally do not play e5. Because what's going to happen is they're probably going to go like take. I don't know if it works here, but like bishop g5, castle, and this f-file is going to be very useful for them. So when they go f4, and it doesn't have to be with the pawn on d4. I've seen this before too. If they go f4, we're going to attack on the queen side. So what we do is we go knight a6, and I think like there's a bunch of like Grishtrikins here. Grishtrikin, I think Kramnik also played it. Knight a6, and then c5 to attack the center. So here, generally they're going to go d5. If they capture, we're just going to go knight takes, and now this is actually great. We've got pressure on e4, can try to get the bishop there, and black has great prospects there. So d5, we're going to go bishop g4, get that bishop out of the way, and generally trade it off, and then try to push b5, b4, c4, and attack on this queen side. And it's actually not so easy for white to really break through without making weaknesses in the center or the king side. So that's what we're going to do against f4. So that's going to cover all the e4 Pirc lines. Now, remember, the great thing about the Pirc or the King's Indian is it's flexible and you can do it against no matter what your opponent plays. So if they go d4, same thing, d6, and let's cover the London first. So with bishop f4, what we're going to do is go knight f6, all same kind of stuff. Nothing really changes. Now here, they need to go h3. If they don't go h3, sometimes you can punish them with knight h5. If they don't go h3, let's say like bishop d3, castle, and let's say like castle, you go knight h5. And now if you get this bishop once again is the sheriff of the dark squares, and c5 is going to give you amazing prospects. So normally you'll see like h3 here, and now we're going to use the golden maneuver, knight f to d7. So here, now we can push e5 because the bishop is also guarding. When you go knight d7, you also have the bishop hitting the e5 square. This, knight c6, and then we're going to go f5 and have a good time here. If they capture, once again, we go knight d takes. That way, this bishop has an easier time of developing. So that's how we're going to counter the London. Now, instead of the London, if they go c4, knight f6, and we'll cover the same-ish first. So the same-ish is when they go f3, and generally, they're going to castle queenside here and really try to attack you. So let's say castle, bishop e3, we go knight d7. Queen d2, and remember, if they're going to attack you on this side, you're going to attack them on this side. So here you don't need to go rook e8, because you're going to attack right off the bat. So here, c5. C5, d5, and there's this one beautiful, beautiful Belyavsky versus John Nunn game, where John Nunn just absolutely lit up white. Went like knight e5, knight h5, f5, and just tore up the king side. It was a very, very beautiful attack. The dark squares sacked a rook, sacked a piece, sacked everything, and then just went on to win that game. So that's how you're going to play against the same-ish, knight d7 and c5. Now a more classical approach is probably like knight f3, bishop g7, and let's say they fianchetto. Fianchetto, castle, and knight c6, and now here we don't want to go e5, because once again, he can trade queens. We don't want to have to deal with that. So here we go, knight d7, the golden maneuver. So if d5, knight c5, we're happy here. We can go e6, try to weaken the center or attack the c-pawn. Those are probably the two targets I would look at there. And if they go e4, we go e5. e5, d5, knight e7, and I think you know what to do from there. f5, f4, and the fun begins. So now instead of fianchetto, if they go e3, we're going to go castle. knight c6, and then once again, the golden maneuver, knight to d7. Knight d7, we're going to push e5, we're going to get a great attack, and then you know what to do from there. e5, f5. So, King's Indian slash Pirc, very easy to play. You're kind of doing the same thing every time, and now you kind of know what to do, or how to punish your opponent if they take different routes, like if they castle queen side, if they go f4, if they do all those kind of stuff, you know exactly what to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, leave a comment. Please like this video, and most importantly, I hope you guys were entertained.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?